Yes, good morning children. This is Venugopal sir. We completed B reading of fourth unit. Now we are going to take up the C reading under the title A Tribute. In the previous lesson also we got this word tribute. Maya Bazaar was a great tribute to Telugu culture, customs and traditions. Like that we got that word. So what actually is called a tribute? Any act or a statement or a gift. Any act, a statement or a gift that is intended to show your admiration or your respect to someone or something. You understand, children? Now, in this lesson, we are going to pay a tribute to one of the greatest artists of Indian cinema, that is Savitri, the most popular heroine of yesteryears, Telugu heroine, of course, and she acted in many other language films also, and she was the only woman heroine to have acted in more than 300 movies. Something is a sort of record. So why we are going to talk about this artist? And we already, in the previous lesson, Maya Bazaar, we discussed she played the most important role in that movie of Shashireka. Around her and her fiancé Abhimanyu only the story revolves. And she is such a great artist that everybody, whoever is acting or whoever acts in a particular way, that woman artist is generally compared to Savitri. That is what is called tribute. What more or what great tribute can be paid to Savitri other than that kind of comparison? Whoever acts in a particular way, that particular woman artist, and the people you generally comment, she is acting like Savitri. That is the greatness of Savitri. Okay, so let us go into the C reading. The Indian film industry has completed 100 years in the year 2013. It's a fitting tribute to the world of cinema to recollect our favorite films, producers, directors, actors, and music and art directors. And of course, Indian cinema completed its 100 years in 2013. Indian film industry, Indian cinema. So generally, on such occasions, when we celebrate the centenary of Indian cinema, it's a fitting tribute. It's an appropriate tribute to the world of cinema to recollect. We have to now recollect our favorite films, our favorite producers, directors, actors and actresses, music and art directors. Why should we recollect them? Because of those great artists and those great music directors or art directors or producers or directors only, Indian cinema has got such a reputation in the world. Indian film industry, of course, produces the highest number of films than any other film industry in the world. That itself indicates the popularity of cinema in India. So, isn't it appropriate on our part to pay tributes to great artists, great directors, great actors and actresses, producers, art directors, music directors, because all these together form a team to make any film successful. And of course, in that way, we also have some great artists to recollect and remember. Telugu audiences are proud of many great producers, directors and artists. See, there is a word artist, A-R-T-I-S-T-E. This is not the word. Compare this word to ARTIST. Look at this word. The difference between artist, ARTISTE, ARTIST. This artist, second one, is a person who just draws paintings or pictures. Whereas this artist is a performer of any art, or is what is called a great performer in the sense, a great artist, a great actor or actress. Such people who excel in a particular field, we all not know that there are 64 arts that we have, and acting is one such art. So those people who act, they are all also called artists. Okay, Indian Telugu audiences are also proud of many great producers, directors and artists. And Savitri is one such prestigious artist. Prestigious means something that we should feel proud of. Savitri is such a prestigious artist for the Telugu audiences. Even after the 40 years of her death, 1980 she died, around 40 years after her death also, Telugu audiences still feel proud about that artist. And up to now there is nobody or no woman artist who can be compared to Savitri. So we are going to talk about that great artist here. In that way, we are going to pay a tribute to one of our most popular cine artists, Savitri, on the occasion of Indian cinema completing 100 years. Ever since she was 8, means just when she was 8 years old, she evinced interest in learning dance. Evinced means to show. Evinced means to show. She started showing interest in learning dance. Later, she associated herself with the theater. She associated herself means what? She came into contact, or she started associating herself with theater. Theater means what? Any building where plays are performed. Don't think that theater is a place where movies are screened. The place or building where movies are screened is called a cinema. What we see on the screen is not cinema. Remember this, children. What we see on the screen is not cinema. Cinema is a building in which movies are screened. Theater is a building where plays are performed on a stage, on a dais. So, she started associating herself with means engaging. Associating is nothing but engaging herself with the theater. She formed a theater organization as well. So, she formed a theater organization with the help of some others. She formed a theater organization as well. She had little difficulty in entering the film field, because she had already an experience there in forming a theater organization and working there in it, acting there as a part of the organization. She had little difficulty, almost no difficulty in entering film field. When Savitri was 12 years, she was offered a role in the film Agni Pariksha, but was finally dropped as she looked too young for the role. When she was 12 years only, Savitri was offered a role in a movie titled Agni Pariksha. But afterwards, once she was picked up, the director and producer felt that she was too young for that role. The role that she had to play in that movie was a little of old age or elderly person's role, but she was just 12 years. So she was dropped from the film because she looked too young for the role. She was given a song sequence, Ranante Ranu, in Patala Bhairavi. Patala Bhairavi is also one of the most famous films produced by Vijaya Productions, in which NTR acted as the hero. It was remade in Hindi with the same title, Patala Bhairavi. Even now also it is one of the most popular Telugu films that is screened on television regularly. In that movie, she was offered a small song sequence. She appears there in a small song sequence. That song is Ranante Rane Ranu. Like that, Savitri's part in it was brief. In that particular song, in that movie, Savitri's role was very brief, very little. But the effect of her performance was considerable. Effect means impact or result. The impact of her performance was considerable. Even though she appears for a very little period, she appears only in a song sequence, her performance was really considerable. Her expressions were beautiful. She conveyed her expressions, even that brief role, in that brief role, that were considered very beautiful. So a lot of filmmakers recognized a potential artist in her. Filmmakers means who are called filmmakers? Directors. A lot of filmmakers, after watching Savitri there in that song sequence in the movie Patal Bhairavi, they recognized a great talent in her, a possible talent, a possible artist. A potential artist means a possible artist they found there in her. Of course, their predictions did not go wrong. She indeed became the top heroine in the Telugu film industry. For almost 20 years, she ruled the Telugu film industry as a queen. She had the lion's share of Telugu films in those days. The maximum number of roles were played by Savitri only in the old Telugu movies. As a result, means as a result of the filmmakers thinking or seeing a possible artist in her, she was elevated to the role of a heroine by the noted director L.V. Prasad in the film Samsaram, which was released in 1950. Elevated means what? She was raised. Elevate means raise or promote. First, she was doing small roles in small song sequences. As a result of recognizing her talent there in that small song sequence in Patal Bhairavi, she was elevated to the role of, she was raised or promoted to the role of a heroine by noted film producer and director L.V. Prasad in the film Samsaram. Samsaram was released in 1950, and NTR and ANR, N.T. Ramarao and Akkineni Nageswara Rao were the heroes there in the movie. They were already by that time very top artists in Telugu film industry. On the sets, when she was invited to act there in the film, on the sets she was nervous. She started feeling nervous. Obviously, when you are doing something for the first time on the stage, you feel nervous. You start shaking and you sometimes forget dialogues. So she felt nervous. She had to repeat many takes, and this proved a setback for her. What do you mean by take? Suppose some particular heroes or heroines take very little time to learn the dialogue that are given to them in a particular situation. In a single take, they can complete their particular dialogue delivery. That is what is called take. She had to repeat many takes. What do you mean by many takes? I told you already. She had to repeat many takes means she had to repeat the same act repeatedly, do the same thing repeatedly, and the director felt it was not correct because she had to complete that without any taking many takes there, just maybe one or two takes, okay, but she failed to deliver the goods there in repeated takes. So finally, that proved to be a setback for her. That proved to be a failure on her part. So what happened as a result? The role was given to someone else and she was given a small role of less import. So what happened as a result? The role was given to someone else. The role that Savitri had to play there in that movie Samsaram was given to somebody else, and she was given a role of less import. Import means significance, importance. She was given a role of less importance there in that movie because she had failed to complete her acting there in the single takes. She had to repeat many takes for every scene. So she was dropped as the main artist and she was given a role of less importance there. In the film Devadasu, 1953 it was released, One of the best picturizations of Sarachandra Chatterjee's novel Devadas, Parvati comes alive in Savitri. I think you might have heard this name, very popular name, Devadas. Devadas, whoever is really drunk or whoever really fails in love and starts getting addicted to drinking alcohol, they always almost are compared to Devadas only. See the popularity of that role. Actually, that was not a real story. It is a movie based on Sharadchandra Chatterjee's novel under the same title, Devadas. And in fact, all the languages, in all the languages, this novel was made into a movie, including Telugu and Hindi. In Telugu, Savitri acted as opposite to Akkineni Nageswara, who acted as Devadas. Vedantam Raghavaya was the director of the movie. One of the best picturizations. The movie was released in 1953. Even now also, the songs in that movie are so popular. Okay, children. In the same way, Telugu's Devadas was considered to be one of the best picturizations of Sarachandra Chatterjee's novel, Devadas. Parvati comes alive in Savitri. What do you mean by Parvati comes alive in Savitri? Parvati, who played the role of Savitri, who played the role of Parvati in that movie, really made such an indelible impression on the minds of the audiences that people started believing that Parvati was none other than Savitri only. In her previous birth, Savitri might be Parvati. That was the main heroine there in the novel, Devadas. And she acted in such a wonderful manner. She played that role. We should not, in fact, say that she lived that role, not she played the role there. She lived there in the role of Parvati. That's why here it is mentioned that in that movie, Parvati comes alive in Savitri, as if Parvati came back to the earth after her death in the form of Savitri, like that people started talking. We can, from that itself, we can understand what a great tribute it is to her. The young Parvati with a curly hair, a lock of hair straying to her forehead, the large round blackberry eyes looking out from an innocent face left an indelible imprint in the minds of all cine lovers. She portrayed Devadas' love and the role of a rich man's wife marvelously. Savitri left her mark in this evergreen Telugu classic. See, with this movie, Savitri made her mark, proved to entire film world, Telugu cine world, that there was no better actress or artist than herself, because she lived the role of Parvati. In that movie, Savitri played the role of Parvati, that means the heroine of Devada or the love of Devadas. At the same time, she played the role of an old man's wife. Because she was forced to marry an old man by her parents, when Devadas' father, who was a zamindar, a very rich man, refused to give Devadas in marriage to Parvati. So Parvati's parents decided that she should get married, and finally they found an old man with many children. That old man was a widower, his wife had died, so she was forced to marry that old man to look after his children, the children of his first wife. So both these roles she played with such an aplomb that people never forget her role there. Whether she was the same Savitri with curly hair, a lock of hair straying onto her forehead, a lock of hair like this falling. You can see that there in the first picture, a lock of hair straying onto her forehead. The large, round blackberry eyes. You know, blackberry is the name of a fruit. the large round blackberry eyes looking out from an innocent face. The audiences were very much confused to know whether the Savitri who played the role of Devadas' love, the mischievous girl and the playful girl, was the same who acted as the role of the old man's wife in that movie. Really spectacular performance. So she made such an indelible imprint in the minds of all cine lovers. Okay, children, we will continue it in the next class. Thank you.